400, almost a 500 on base percentage. Well, today is the day that Germán Márquez gets to take the ball, and that's always a good thing, as we were talking about.
And they need a stopper. When you've lost 8 out of the last 10, you need your guy to go out there and put the team on his back. And that's asking a lot, an awful lot, but if there's one guy that can do it, it's Germán. 99th career start. And since he had that one rough outing back in July of last year against San Francisco, what he's been able to accomplish here at Coors Field has been really great. His last start probably didn't have his best stuff overall, but when you think about it, still getting through six innings, just two earned runs, three strikeouts, his fastball, he was spraying it, but he always made the pitch when he needed to, got help with a couple of ground ball double plays. So for Germán, 2-1 in his last four Coors start, what I was talking about a moment ago, 30 strikeouts, just four walks, and two of those four came in his last start. So he's in a good spot here, likes pitching here. But when you look at this staff overall, a starting pitching ERA of 3.44. Fourth best in the National League, sixth in all of baseball. So starters have been doing their thing.
And yesterday was an aberration. It's really the first time this year the Rockies got blown out. They had one other game where they lost by a significant margin, but really the first time that the game really got away from them in the middle innings. And it's because of that starting rotation. They have been outstanding. You know the Rockies have to swing the bats. We've talked a lot about that already. So we are set for afternoon baseball at Coors Field. It's the Rockies. It's the Astros. Come on back to 20th. Good afternoon for Dusty Baker. Here's the Southwest starting nine. Jose Altuve, he'll bat second. Carlos Correa, he had four hits yesterday, including a homer. Josh Reddick, Yuli Gurriel, Kyle Tucker had a big ball game yesterday as well. A couple of triples and a homer. Abraham Toro's in at third base. Alex Bregman had to be placed on the injured list with that hamstring. Taylor Jones at first base, and Martin Maldonado catching and batting ninth. And there's number 48 getting set to go. Germán looking for his third victory of the year. Minuscule ERA of 2.25.
And also 30 strikeouts on the season in 32 innings. Right now he sits at 597 strikeouts for his career. Pretty impressive number for Germán. Fastball, slider, curveball, changeup like we've come to expect from him. And everything as far as off-speed pitches, 200 average or below. You know, the changeup is the highest at 200. And then the slider, the wipeout slider, and his curveball.
First pitch of the ball game, rubs defensively. There have been a couple of changes. This is Buddy's trying to shake things up, get that offense going. Tap, we mentioned at the top of the lineup. He's in left field. Sam Hilliard's in center. Charlie in right, Arenado in Story, Brendan Rodgers at second base. He got a couple ABs yesterday, had a hit. McMahon slides to first. It's a ninth time, now 10th time this year he's been at first base. And Tony Walters behind the plate. Tony got in the ball game late yesterday and had... Afternoon for Buddy Black. Tapia, Story, Charlie Blackman, last 10 and still close to 400. He leads baseball at 426. Arenado, Murphy, McMahon, Rogers, Hilliard, and Tony Walters against a 23-year-old right-hander from Santo Domingo in the Dominican Republic, Christian Javier. And like several other young pitchers the Rockies have faced this year, he has done quite nicely, Huey.
And when you look at his stuff and what he's been able to accomplish, just a 153 batting average against, it's a fast.
Springer Reddick in the outfield. Toro again at third for Alex Bregman, who's on the 10-day IL with the hamstring he strained last night on a double. Correa and Altuve, their normal double play combination naturally. Taylor Jones giving Yuli Gurriel a day off, at least defensively. Gurriel's in the lineup as the DH. And here's how Bregman got hurt yesterday. Kind of sliced the ball down the right field line. And as he was approaching first, he grabs his right hamstring. And I know they put out a report later in the game that, what was it, right hamstring tightness or something along those lines, and he's day-to-day. And not only from personal experience,